When I am in an MSc committee at my university, I often ask students questions like this. What are your dependent and independent variables, and how many are there? And this type of questions, unfortunately, too often leads to a lot of confusion with the almost graduated students. And that's a pity, because this is actually the start of every model. While we partly understand the confusion of the students, a dependent variable in one model may be an independent variable in another. A variable in one model may be a parameter in another model. This is highly dependent on the model you have in mind. But what do we mean by dependent and independent variables and parameters? Well, that's what you will learn in this video. We'll use an example. This video is not about this example, that's not the point, but it's just to illustrate what we mean by dependent variables, etc. So our example will be our good old mass on the spring. So the mass is moving in the x direction only, no gravity involved, and the friction force equals minus k times x. So the normal harmonic oscillator. So then we know the equation of motion, m times acceleration equals minus k times x. So what are our independent variables and dependent variables in this case? Well, the independent variable will be t. We want to find x, the displacement x, as function of t. So our dependent variable, the one we want to find, is x. But x will, in the end, depend on t. T may be chosen freely. And then in the end, we want to find x as a function of t. That's the goal of our model. So that's the idea of independent and dependent variables. T can vary freely, but once t is given, we know x. So what are parameters in this case? Well, those are the things that we, within the model, will use as constants. In this case, for example, the spring constant k, the mass m, and the initial position and initial velocity x0 and v0. And once those are given, those four parameters, then the model is fully specified, and you can compute your x of t. Now, I extend this slightly. If you, for example, include the frictional force minus c times v and an exterior force f0 sine omega not times t, then you know Newton's law, sum of the forces equals m times a, sum of the forces over here. So you get the differential equation like this. Now let's see, how many parameters do we have over here? Now we still want to find x as a function of t. But there are now many parameters involved. Of course, still the m and the k are still there. Over here and over here. Still the starting position is involved, but we have gotten a few more, like c and f naught and omega. Those are all given parameters. So we want to find x as a function of t. That will depend on all the parameters you choose, m, etc. But now, next question is coming. How many parameters can you actually choose very independently? For example, if you would multiply m, c, k, and f0, if you would multiply them all by 2, the model remains the same. So it doesn't make sense to vary those independently. So then that question, how many parameters can you actually vary independently? That's another question which we'll leave for the next video.